Baltimore and DC now.
Can't forget that Motor City.
Can't forget the Motor City.
All way down in L.A., California.
Way down in L.A., California.
Not to mention half like Nova Scotia.
Doesn't mention it, please.
Or Lombard. You visit Lebedev. Cream, you know.
Yes, I know.
Okay, it's
Manchester.
It's early afternoon. And this thing has started. Let's go see if we can get some people mad at us.
Somewhere along the line.
That's Ken Bernard on the right and Mr. Wendell Ross on the left.
Jack in the swap.
Is he quiet or is he making a fuss? Is he doing a slip?
What? Jack in the swap.
Does he wear a white tie? He dines in the red.
Beefalo burgers, man.
Beefalo? Burgers from buffalo? No.
You could say,
burgers from beef? No.
You could say 3/8 if it's buffalo. That's 37.5%.
I see.
At least have less.
5/8 of it is beef.
Less cholesterol?
Definitely less cholesterol.
More healthy for you?
Definitely healthier. So you can eat one of these and tank up on chips and you'll
be good. Let's go. Party, party, party.
That's Chris's mother, May Boggia.
There's that little pain in the neck kid.
I'm not a pain in the neck. Ooh, take a picture of yourself.
Of myself? I know what I look like. I just don't know what you look like. Ooh, you're funny looking.
That's a Georgia. So
when do I push?
It's already running.
All right. So perfect. You got your hair. What? You see that?
Get Chipper's hair.
I had first cycle.
Don't laugh. She did the best she doesn't know how.
I tried to talk her out of it.
Did you?
Yeah.
I think you look cute, Chip.
Really?
Hey, Chip,
kind
of like an Anglo Buffy.
Try again.
What's your second choice?
Between
Oliver
Hardy and...
How do I turn it off? Push the old button, Rooney.
Did you graduate from Oliver Hardy?
This one?
Yeah.
Because basically what it comes down to is they figure out how much you can afford to pay, and then they make up the rest with grants. So if she went to ACC, she'd pay X every amount and get $2,000 in grants. If she goes to Bryn Mawr, she'd get X amount, she gets $20,000. So that's an interesting problem.
Chris, I told Chris I would not go back to work when she was one. I says, it's just too crazy. And he said to me, he says, well, he says, if I stay home, would you go to work? And I says, well, if you stayed home, then it wouldn't be quite so crazy. So yes, so I went back to work to keep the wolf from the door. And Chris stayed home. And so he was sort of working on the house and, you know, and picking up odd jobs here and there to keep the family afloat. Because when I'm home, I just stay home. So anyway, so Chris was home and, you know, we call up at work. So one day I call up at work and I said, what's going on? He says, oh, he says, the Baltimore's calling me and they wanted to use one of our horses, and they're doing a photo layout for a men's sweater magazine, and they wanted to use one of the horses. So that's interesting. So we're going down, take the horses down to the Balsam House. Oh, that's interesting. So that weekend, I'm home writing reports or something, and he and the guy who worked with him are painting, working on the house, and they're talking, and all of a sudden, I hear him sort of filters into my consciousness. Well, what about those models? I said, Chris, what models? He says, so I told you they were doing men's sweater magazines. I says, yeah, but Chris, you're not talking about men models. He says, well, no. He says, there were women there too. I said, you didn't tell me. He says, oh, yeah, well, there were women models there too. All right, so now it flips to the winter, right? And we're doing sleigh rides. And this guy comes in and he says, oh, tell Chris that that magazine is ready. I said, what magazine? He says, back in the fall, the sweater magazine. So he comes back with the magazine. This is beautiful, you know, 8.5 by 10, beautiful, glossy, expensive sweater magazine. And they never paid Chris for doing this. And on the front covers our horse, you know, these models and these guys in their fancy magazines. And the guy says, by the way, do you recognize this man? I says, well, he looks familiar. He says, well, that's the Winston man. I think he's the man that does the anti-smoking commercials now. Mm-hmm. But he was the model in that magazine. This is high-class stuff. And I said, do you recognize the woman? And I says, no. He says, well, that's Miss March. And I think, Freudian block, right? March is dairy month. This is Miss March. I says, no, I don't recognize Miss March. I think, what is going on? And I flip the page. And there's a picture of the view from my kitchen window. Mrs. March is sitting on my fence. Wait a second, now Chris didn't tell me they took pictures here. And Chris didn't tell me Miss March was here. So Chris comes in that day and I go, Chris, what's the story about Miss March? And he goes, huh? I says, Chris. And I tell him the whole story. He goes, oh, yeah, he said. Well, she had a bad personality. I says, Chris, she didn't become this March for her personality. I says, and you didn't tell me she was at the house? And he says, oh, didn't I tell you that?
Oh, jeez.
I said, no, wait a second. I said, they had a change when they were here, right? He says, yeah. He says, where did they change? He says, oh, in the bathroom. Now, if you notice our bathroom door, they're old doors, and the doorknobs were low, and Chris took the doorknobs out and put them up higher, and there was a hole this big where the doorknob was. Well, he's since filled it in with wood putty, but it was not filled in with wood putty now. Then, right? And I said, let me get this straight. Chris Boggia is painting a house, Mr. Mom, in the end of, you know, nowhere, USA. Knock, knock, knock on the door. Miss March, can I come in and try sweaters on?
Sounds like every man.
And that's what happened.
Oh, God.
But you should have seen when he went on
Chestertown. And I didn't get paid either.
Yeah, you never got paid. Yeah, right. But the
look
story
at this
is
guy, I never got paid.
Now, on top of that, when he went back to Chestertown, my brother.
I didn't even know who she was at the time.
Yeah, but my brother got you.
Okay, here it is. 37 years after Eunice Wakely had this group. Here they are. Look at them all. There's Chip with his broken hat 37 years later.
Simulated broken hat.
Simulated broken hat.
Picture, George.
Picture.
Excellent. Mrs. Wakely, there she is.
Barbara, zoom in on the picture.
I don't know how to zoom.
That's our graduation picture.
How do I zoom, Chip?
From
Zoom. How do I do it?
Kindergarten.
Move?
Get it, Chip?
Yeah.
What are you telling me?
Well, yeah, we're getting it. Ooh.
I like that.
We have to narrate this later.
All right, can you identify
Jennifer,
your kids?
You're weaving
like
back
left
and forth.
Right?
I know, I'm focusing that way.
Oh. You're focusing?
I thought you were just breathing.
Suppose I do pointing. Like, who's this?
Yeah,
this was taken 1655.
That's you?
Yes.
There's Dr. Dave.
Good idea. That's darn close.
And who's this? Who's the next guy?
Hold this next chipper so you can...
Okay.
No, Beth's in the middle.
Beth is here?
No, this is Beth with the braids.
That's Beth with the braids. All right, you know who this is? No one knows? Who's this?
Carol Ellsworth. That's Kathy.
That's Kathy.
Is Linda Gannon in there?
That's Peter.
She's in there.
That's right. Linda Canyon is the one next to me.
Okay, who's this?
I had big brown eyes and I had my hair all
He flunked out.
He flunked out.
Jared.
See, Mrs. Jared. Wakely, you didn't get them all. Who's this with the crooked hat?
Chris Tennyson.
Who's this with a tassel on his face?
He left us after a year or two.
And this is
Mrs. Wakely.
Mrs. Wakely, who's this?
I don't know, but she's cute.
Oh, she's Moffat. Moffat, who's this?
We didn't have any Moffats in kindergarten.
Carol Ellsworth. No. Carol Ellsworth?
That was this one.
And who's this little? Oh, who's this little guy?
That's Kevin Hayes.
That's Kevin Hayes.
And this?
Lynn. That's Lynn.
And Carol Ann.
That's Carol Ann. That's Chipper.
Chipper with his hat broken. Who's this little guy half hidden?
He left us.
He left us.
There was a kid named Hayes in there in kindergarten. What was his first name?
Oh, yeah.
Another Hayes.
Kevin Hayes.
No, not Kevin. Another one.
He left.
He would have been Luella Walker's nephew.
You're good, George. You're good.
Luella, shoot. I can't remember his name now.
Now, Chip, did you get this?
Not yet. No.
Oh, okay.
You really want to take your time for this. Can I stop carrying
this? Yeah.
Thomas Hayes. Remember Thomas Hayes?
Thomas Hayes.
You remember?
Kindergarten. Mm-hmm. Who remembers what Mr. Sumi used to say when he wanted to take one more?
One more.
Tell me when you want me to open.
Okay.
Something like that.
I think my brother actually was in your college year before he then moved down to Warren.
Yeah, that was the year they split off.
Down by Charlie Leggett.
Yes,
they had two straight
splits.
She was with us.
And that's up.
Oh, and that's 2 years ago.
This is just 2 weeks.
Yeah, she was with us.
Then I would pick up more. But it's I just got this phone.
This has got Zoom. Where's your wisdom, Chris?
No words from
you? Boy, these guys have learned a lot. Who else am I hiding? Carol, Chip. There he goes.
Very important words.
Let's hear it.
Real careful with that camera.
Really? Who else? George Wertheim, where is he? The original Dave Clark of North Warren.
She won't let it go.
What do you have?
I don't have any.
You have no words of wisdom? No. Well, you pontificate all you want?
Maybe you give Peter a turn.
Where's Peter? Oh, he was hiding.
I'm saving my words of wisdom for the next PM.
For the next PM?
I remember the first day I was in school up here. I had to be taught not to stand up when I was.
When you were spoken to?
Spoken to.
Really? Oh, yeah, much more relaxed atmosphere up here. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because every time you had to answer the nuns, you had to stand up.
Yeah. You and Santa share stories.
Well, you had to be ready because if you didn't know your answer, you got sent to the back of the room. Okay. Didn't know your time
so
table.
So you had to be on your feet.
Go to the back of the room, write time table 10 times.
Oh, God.
In the early grades, I never learned anything like phonics. We learned everything by rote.
Oh, yeah?
Really? Rote.
I hated phonics, but we had
it. You hated it.
It's like I hated penmanship. I hated it.
Yeah, but she didn't write nice. She read like her mother. I don't write like that at all. I can't imagine.
Thanks again.
When we first started school, I remember there was like 67 kids in the first grade class.
Wow.
We went to school from 9 to 12, and we went home for an hour, and then from 1 to 3.
Huh.
There was no gym, no specials, no nothing. Just
straight
basic,
school.
Straight school.
Yeah. I don't think I remember this.
But have you always got a picture?
I don't know. You're the only one.
I'm the only one?
You're the only one.
Did you hear what I thought about
chip. Uh-oh. He had his, that hat on, and Sarah had braided his hair and put hair things in it.
Either Mel
and I said
curly.
A cross between Oliver Hardy and Buckwheat.
Don't call him Tim Conway.
Tim Conway, there you go. Okay, Dr. Dave. What do we got to do with Dr. Dave?
Oh, absolutely.
I've been very careful. I've been very careful.
Your wheelies are
coming. Doing donuts on the quad?
Yeah.
Up and down the steps?
You should throw more parties.
I will.
Everybody thinks I did this. I did. Zip, Chip, and Chris. I changed, guys.
It's the yearbook staff.
You know what? You forgot the little soldiers.
Those little guys.
Just one little soldier.
Pictures.
Oh,
one.
Yeah, guy. And every picture. Guy.
Right.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't know what happened to him.
Here we go.
You put a little
in the soldier.
I don't know. Chip, she's got to put little soldiers in the yearbook.
Yeah.
This year, in honor of the class of in honor of the class.
Bye, everybody.
Everybody's like back in the air.
Isn't that adorable? And then didn't you do something with your fingers in that too?
Yes.
There was one glove that got misplaced.
There was also a glove in your
pocket. So we ought to get to know.
What?
Sure.
Face to parade.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
My God.
A chipper. Look at this picture of Chipper. Looks
the guy in there was wearing that chin. How does it look like that? Look.
Same hair, do you want to throw a little mustache?
Yeah, go ahead. You draw it on yours.
All the eyebrows.
Now you got to go to Florida to get away from the
Chipper. Yeah, that's right. Something will happen. Isn't that great?
I always thought the cherry picture was
well,
fun.
Mom, yeah.
I provided that.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, we got it.
Yeah.
Isn't the choice mix?
Annie.
Thank you, Barbara.
You can ride up front with the horses.
He's allergic to the horses.
I'd probably be the one doing the most sneezing, too, but anyway.
I don't want to ride a horsey.
Jim Bentover.
Should have said so earlier before
not
I put
nice
it out.
Still.
I know she got some English saddles in there. They just some lessons or got the trail.
No, you can go.
Chip, did you get out of the yearbook?
Wait a minute, I'm going to grab the video.
No.
Get the yearbook in the video.
When, how do your
great.
Trail rides work? Do they go out at a certain time, or do you have to have a certain amount of people? They just,
Chris,
you just come and you look
like to
that.
Look to the yearbook. That's so bit,
what was everybody laughing at?
Are you going to take pictures?
Apparently.
No.
Do the baby pictures, but Chip looks exactly like he does now. Same hair doing everything.
About the mustache. We'll start
all
here.
He wants is a mustache.
Wendell's playing quite a bit away.
I didn't know him. I did not know.
Okay, where's the little army man in this picture?
I asked. I said, who's that over there? And they said, Wendell. I really couldn't believe it.
At first, from a distance, I thought James D. Wentworth was sure put out a lot of money.
He never shut up, did he?
He called.
He says, bionic woman. It's true.
I remember Mr. LaRock. He did not help much at all. I work with Kay for a lot.
Yeah,
he said that. She was an aide in school.
When
he was on the force me to take physics.
Very well.
Like I was going to need it my whole senior year.
He'll be up probably in a week and a half or so. He'll be up for the summer.
Isn't this nice?
And Lady Lake, he just moved up there about a year ago. He
was Clarence Meade died.
Yeah,
just 2 years ago.
So he goes back and forth every year.
Like it there after a while. Yeah, he'll come up for the summer and stay with his brother months ago. And then he'll go back down September, October. But
we all had him for so many years.
Oh, I know.
He had a small heart.
Yeah, I lived with him. I know. he had a small heart attack.
Remember the thing? And Stan was looking, trying to figure out where that
was.
It was a bird.
Oh, I see.
You know, he's having a heart attack.
He's a tough guy.
Indigestion. They don't know what they're talking about. You know, but he's fine.
Because he was the coach of all of our teachers.
So you got an hour.
The toughest one.
You think so?
Check it out.
He was tough on me because he didn't want anyone to think that I was treated any differently.
Oh my God,
so not that I minded or it hurt me or bothered me, but he was tough on me. He and Wendell. I mean, I couldn't move half an inch and somebody knew it. You know, I couldn't sneak away to Lake George.
Yeah, every time we got caught, right?
Oh dear.
No,
they're really biting now.
Yes.
Loves you.
He won't hurt you.
Okay, what's the game plan?
I'll meet you at the tea house at 9 o'clock, and then we're going to Warrensburg, right?
Yeah. Are you guys coming?
If you're not there at 9 o'clock, I'm not walking in by myself.
Lynn and I can't dance together. They'll think you know what.
You're grown up. You don't have to worry about people.
When it comes to that, I'm not real. Well, now, to a point, you got a point. I'm getting tired. This is awesome.
It's 9 o'clock.
Keep me going.
Okay. P.S.
Okay. Let me stop.
Then we'll go to Jaeger's and listen to some music.
All right.
Yeah, well, there's no sense in taking 29 cars if we're all going. Right?
What are you doing, Chris? You going to go?
Not for a while. They're going to go.
I've got your pamphlet.
Come with me now to Glenn's Falls. Make the trip fast.
You
don't take off
the car with that?
Oh,
I'm going in that direction.
Wait, you are what? Why don't you take me?
Okay.
What's
the camera?
We actually can't.
That would be exciting.
All right. Okay. Just wanted to say,
you're welcome. I haven't planted
mine either. What's that?
I haven't planted mine either.
Lynn and I are sowing seeds tonight.
Well, what? What'd she say?
In that case, maybe I'll come.
She said you're in a lot of trouble. You're going to be out all night.
Oh, God. She said you're sowing seeds tonight.
No, seriously, are you guys coming tonight?
That would be interesting.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll probably be late.
How late?
You were late last night.
I can't tell because I'm going to go to Glens Falls and back with Barbara.
Okay. Well, like she said, we'll be at either the Panther House or the Jaeger House.
If it's 10 o'clock, we'll be at the Jaeger House. We're only having one quick drink because Lynn and I have a freebie coming to the P House. Then we're leaving the P House.
Some old man, he was 95 years old, came in and bought us a drink.
It's my mother's neighbor. He thinks myself and my daughter can do no wrong.
He thinks he can handle two of you?
Never know.
Bye. Yeah, do we inherit?